Good afternoon to everyone. The previous class, we have seen what are the different frame formats or what are different items which are involved in ESP and AH. All these things have been seen. Today, we would like to go through what are the where exactly AH will be inserted in the frame. Where exactly inserted in the IP frame, and ESP can be inserted where in IP frame, and what are different activities which could be done by these two, and what are the services provided by IPsec. So what are the security services provided by IPsec will be studied today. So let us have a look here. So here, authentication protocol is designed to authenticate the source, that is the source entity is being authenticated by providing the integrity of the data which is being carried out from source to destination here, otherwise server to client to server or server to client here. Here you need to understand the payload, the term payload will be original plain text which is being processed, will be so call it as a payload here, and it is user to provide, AH is user to provide authentication of the source entity, okay, source host or source entity, maybe you could consider. And here this protocol can be used two different types of cryptographic activities. Number one activity will use a hash function. So generally, to generate this particular hash value, it has been used. So SHA SHA-512 has been used for generating so hashing hash value, and a symmetric key. So to generate, to transfer this particular symmetric key, it could be used for Diffie-Hellman key, Diffie-Hellman key exchange algorithm. So these are the two different kinds of things which are used to. Used as a cryptographic algorithms in authentication header protocol. And then followed by, after finding this message digest, that digest is being inserted in the authentication header. Yesterday we have seen how this could be. Of course, today also we'd like to concentrate on that. So after placing the particular location, after placing this message digest into the authentication header, then this whole authentication header will be placed into IP protocol packet. IP protocol packet here. So it could be placed based on the mode. So if it is transport mode, so it could be taken 50, and if it is a tunnel mode, it could be taken 51. Let me explain what is the 50 and 51. So soon we have to take that particular value. What is the particular value here? So here an IP packet will be seen in such a way. So in the beginning, so it has been having so IP header. The IP header have a complete information. 32-bit long header will be introduced here. This is just a complete information regarding to internet protocol, and then followed by AH authentication header protocol. Actually, we have seen this particular total authentication header protocol segment here. So in this, we have next header, payload length, and the resolve bits, security parameter index, and sequence number. Whatever the hash value which has been identified by using SHA-512 that has been introduced here, and everything will be placed into placed into this particular IP packet after IP header, and then if there is any extra information which is required, that could be placed here. And the padding will be, generally this SHA algorithm can be taken 512 bits as input. If your IP packet could not be satisfied the length in 512 bits, then padding will be gets added here. If total length of this particular IP packet will be 512 bits, there is no problem. No padding will be gets added here. So if it is less than 512, so how many number of bits are left over, those many number of zeros, only zeros will be so padded here in this particular field here. So So padding might be varied from packet to packet. One packet might be having the 512 bits will be there. One packet might be having only so 250 bits or 200 bits will be there. Then remaining everything will be padded with zeros only. Some packets might be full-fledged 512 bits will be there. Then padding could not be, even single bit of padding could also not be available here. So this padding is useful for only identifying or producing the hash function's output, that is message digest. So a SHA-512 can be taken 512 bits as input. So that is why based on the size of this particular total entire packet, so if anything will be left over or anything will be in short of 512 bits, then padding will be appended. Otherwise, no requirement of padding which is being taken into consideration. Okay, so that is what the authentication, and followed by it while stuffing this particular AH authentication header so into this IP packet, it could be followed some 4 to 5 rules and regulations. Number one, authentication header is added to the payload with the authentication data field which is being set to 0. So authentication data field will be set to 0 while authentication field will be available with IP header, with this particular IP header. So that could be set to 0, then the packet which is being processed by using the AH protocol. If it is 1, obviously that could be ESP protocol. Okay, padding may be added to the total length of even particular hashing algorithm. So just before I have told you, that is SHA-512 can be applied on this particular total packet to identify the hash value, otherwise the checksum value, otherwise message digest value, all are same. All these words are synonyms and everything is same in the perception of cryptography. So therefore, to identify the message digest, so padding could be gets added based on the requirement. If there is no requirement, so padding could not be there. If required, based on the length of the particular packet, which is in short of 512, that much amount of continuous zeros are going to be padded at the end. And then hash value could be gets operated on the total length. Total length in the sense, as I said, digest is just quoted. So it could be taken, so 512 bits of data. So this total packet size will be 512 bits. So on this particular total 512 bits, SHA-512 will be gets operated, then hash value could be gets appended here. So authentication data will be introduced by AH. Authentication data in the sense of here, the AH value is introduced for producing AH protocol completely. Okay, these are the four items which could be taken into consideration where we have to providing some kind of security to the host-to-host or router-to-router using AH. Okay, so this is what the information, the segment length and where exactly the segment is going to be appended to the packet, complete packet, everything will be related to this particular protocol, AH protocol, something like this. And second thing is ESP. ESP in the sense encapsulating security payload. So how this could be, so whatever the discussions we made at this particular point, next header and security parameter index and the sequence number and authentication data, everything, what not everything, everything is common for AH and ESP, but so ESP can be added as header and ring. ESP can be added, so AH's entire AH segment will be added at one place, where EH will be gets added in two places. One is at header place and the second one is at the trailer place. In between these two, we have actual payload data. Okay, so that is the one difference here. Let us have a look at this particular thing. So EH protocol could not provide any privacy to the data. Privacy cannot be provided. Rather, it could be provides So source authentication and data integrity. Source authentication in the sense who is sending, whether the person who is sending the data is authenticated person or not, or authenticated IP address or not, could be provided, and the data integrity could be provided. Whereas ESP provides source authentication, in addition to source authentication, integrity and the privacy also gets provided. Integrity will be based on both on data or source, and both integrity will be gets provided by ESP here. And very important point to be understand, so in AH protocol, there is no header. AH header and AH driver cannot be there, where ESP can be added in two different places. One is at header, payload, before payload as header, after payload as trailer, it is being added here. So that is why, so it could be provided, so this privacy also. Okay, look at this. ESP's authentication could be added at the end of the packet. Thereby, so in AH packet, thereby it is being added with the padding. So zeros will be gets padded over there. So therefore, the size of the particular packet will be reached to 512 or not would be known by that. But here, so ESP has been, the data, entire data will be divided into two different portions. One is header and second one is trailer. So that here also, using SHA-512 only to identify this particular authentication digest, I mean message digest also be used here with 512 only. So SHA-512, okay, here also the same thing can be used, but the data which is being disseminated in the sense segregated in different places, rather AH protocol. Okay, so that is what you need to understand here. Look at this IP header, complete IP information, whether it is IPv4 or IPv6, that IPv information, followed by so IP ESP header, and then whatever the data you wanted to propagate here, that the entire data here, payload will be called as the data here, and then ESP trailer, and then authentication data. So normally, if you consider here, you could see security index parameter and security parameter index and sequence number, followed by look at this pad length and next header, everything will be combined in AH, whereas in ESP they have been divided into three partitions. One is at ESP header, second one is at ESP trailer, and the final authentication data will be at end of the packet. Okay, I'll go to previous slide one more time. Look at this. So next header data and next header, then followed by payload length and the reserved, followed by SPA sequence number and authentication data. Everything will be combined together and will be called as so AH protocol. Whereas so this particular thing has been divided into three different types of partitions. First partition is ESP header, and second partition is ESP trailer, and third one is authentication data. Authentication data in the sense that is the message digest, which is being identified by SHA. Okay, so everything could be taken into consideration and will be placed and will be appended at right places of this total packet. Okay, then what are the procedure, what is the procedure which is being followed to frame this particular ESP here in the sense? Number one, ESP could be added trailer after the payload. After the payload, trailer can be added here, and then the payload can be, payload and trailer can be encrypted and identify this message digest, and then followed by after encryption could be gets identified, then header will be gets added here. After header, so ESP header, payload, ESP trailer can be used to authenticate the specific data here, and then authentication data will be always used to add at the end of the packet only. That we have discussed so here. And if you want to consider you are sending that particular packet using ESP protocol, so the IP header value will be 50, and the same thing will be sent by using AH protocol, that would be considered as 51. So So IP header, so the protocol value will be 51, that is AH protocol. AH protocol, you are using so AH protocol to prepare the entire packet. Whereas if you use 50, you are trying to incorporate ESP protocol into your packet. So that is the identification to be identified for this particular thing. You need to understand. And of course, I have given same thing here. Okay. So here in IP header, so the protocol value will be 51. That is AH protocol implementation. And the protocol value will be 50, that is ESP protocol implementation. And finally, what are the services provided by IPsec? Look at this. So access control will be provided by both AH and ESP. Both of those has been provided. So access control, message authentication will be provided by both this particular protocols which have been implemented, and entity authentication, that is source authentication, will be provided by both protocols, whereas confidentiality cannot be provided by AH protocol, where confidentiality will be provided by ESP. And any attacks, attack protection, that attacks protection will be taken care by both protocols here. Normally, AH protocol can be used to send the data using transmit mode, whereas ESP can be send the data tunnel mode. So tunnel mode, in the sense, most probably this tunnel mode can be included. So router to router, data transmission. So need not be a host. You are supposed to consider as a tunnel. So the communication endpoints need not be host. That might be router to router, otherwise router to host, or host to router, or host to host. Anything will be happening using tunnel. Whereas a transmit mode, in the sense, it must be always host to host only, end to end only. So that is what you need to identify the difference between these two. So AH will be generally implemented for transmit mode. And tunnel will be generally implemented for router to router. So that point must be remembered by you. So this is what the complete IPsec protocol, which is used to provide security on web services. Okay, web services security will be provided by using IP security, something like this. This is the end of IP security. IP security has gets over. Let me open your syllabus one more time. What is the leftover item which is being discussed here? Let us have a look. So here, so we have discussed this particular IP security. It's over. Then only one topic is left over here, that is system security. System security is left over with us. So after completion of this particular, okay, let me